Hi everyone, this is part 5, I believe, of the how to train and plan and program for the planche. And this is programming for the planche here today live. I thought it would be a good idea to just sum everything that we talked about and to combine all the exercises, the variations, the progressions, the weight, the repetitions, everything, and to give you a better idea of where to start practically. I will program the front lever simultaneously because they work great as antagonistic movement patterns. And I will program for intermediates because most of the people that approach me are intermediates. They are stuck before that straddle planche hold around that advanced stuck planche area. And I believe that this would be a great general program for 90% of you. I do recommend, I advise you to take that template and apply all the individual traits that you need in order to make this program your program. This is a heavy light medium program, which is more like a template, inspired a lot by Andy Baker, which has a lot of great YouTube videos here. You should definitely search that up, and also great written material, Andy Baker. Heavy light medium is a training template, great for intermediate lifters. The stress recovery adaptation cycle is completed within a week. We progress once a week. We are no longer beginners, and we do 3 times a week. One heavy session, one light session, which is also referred as a recovery session, and one medium session. We do possess some stimulative responses, but don't demand as much recovery as the heavy session. Here on the board, we have the heavy session. This is the hot session, meaning the most important session in the week. This is the session that you will break your PRs. You will set new standards. You should come the most prepared for that session. And then the next session, the light and the medium, are following their percentages accordingly. Okay, programming for the planche. We will start with the main work. Isometric straddle planche hold, because that's the most specific, and isometric front lever hold, because that's the most specific to our goals, the isometric holds. This will be our main work. You can do that in a superset A1, A2, or just keep them straight sets, all the planche work, then all the front lever work. At some stage, this is the preferred variation. Okay, you will start with a general warm-up, then a specific warm-up going through tuck planche, and then assistant bends with a lot of weight. So the isometric straddle planche hold, which obviously you can't do yet, you're doing with bend assistance. Okay, so you did the general warm-up, and then let's say you start with 50% straddle planche hold, meaning the other 50% the bend assistant takes, and then 60%, 70, and then 80%, and then you're completely warmed up, the nervous system is amped up. We're ready for our first set, which is also our top set, the most crucial set. This is, if that is the hot session, that's the hot set. Top set, which is 10 second hold plus. So an MRAP set. A plus set like this is a great autoregulatory set to insert in your programming to take into consideration better or worse days. It's a great idea to have. So this is the top set. This is also the set that you will log the exact amount of time. You will come the most prepared. You will have the vision of how many seconds you want to get. So you will actually go for more than 10. You should be able to if you program with less than the true 10 second max weight with the saddle planche hold, bend assisted. And let's say you got 13 seconds. Great, that's great, that's week one. Then you will take 90% of the weight, meaning you will add a little bit of bend tension and continue for the subsequent sets four sets of 10 seconds to get more volume. This could also be looked at as supplementary work. If you're a very like methodical, analytical guy, just keep doing this isometric side planche hold, the same exercise. If you want that really seeks variation, you can do those subsequent, the following sets with a variation of the planche, which could be planche push-ups. Okay, but that would be the programming for today. Just adding bent tension and doing 10 seconds started planche holds isometrically. The same would do for the front lever. We start with, after the general and specific warm-up, the top set. It's a plus set, as many reps as possible, or seconds in our case. And let's say you got 13, just for the sake of the video, seconds again. Great, great for week one. Then, instead of weight, for the sake of simplicity, instead of band assistant, we will use variation. So you drop one variation prior to that. So let's say if you walked the half lay, now we will do the straddle, which is usually slightly easier. And you will do four sets of 10 seconds to get more volume. You need volume in your workouts, okay? You have the intensity, the intent, and then you have more volume, which is crucial for progress. And also practicing technique, everything. Okay, so you did the main work. That should be the most focused. It will also take you more time because you will take more rest intervals in between. Great, that's 80% of programming. If you were to stop now, the program will still be efficient, still be great program. What is our progression model? So we take week one. We said that this is like a 7 week stress recovery adaptation cycle. So each week we are actually progressing. The first week you did 30 seconds, 13 seconds in the top set. We are keeping the same weights, 15 the second week, because you knew what to aim to, you got 2 seconds more. Third week, 18, 21, okay? So look at the progress that you've made, significant amount of progress, and that will be around time to probably add weight and then rinse and repeat. You add 5 kilograms or decrease 5 kilograms of bent tension. In the front lever, you jump a variation with the leverage, and then rinse and repeat. Week one, you'll probably be around 30 seconds again because you added weight. Only after you've done a deload, that will be a great place to insert the deload week. Then week six will actually be like a week one all over again, but with an additional weight. That's the progression model. You run this model as long as you can. Don't change something that works. Great. You got the main work, you got the progression model of the main work. You wrote the top sets, most crucial sets in your training log. You are way ahead of the curve. Now it's time for accessories to finish working on the muscles, not the movement, in order to push our athletic potential ceiling, to widen our base, our athletic base. So push-ups and bodyweight rows, we will do supersets. This is a great place to do the supersets, even giant sets, more time under tension, complexes, that would be a good place to insert them. Push-ups, anything in the 15 to 25 rep range, we're looking for time under tension. We're not really looking to exert too much force and intensity. Here we already done that, and we want to keep those resources for the main work and our next workout's main work. Then another superset, bicep curls and dips, which will be more arm specific than chest and back. Again, 10 to 15 repetition range. You don't want to go too lower here, so the weight won't be too taxing. Okay, so this was the heavy session. We programmed the heavy session together. It is the hot session, but we also have the light session and the medium. And by heavy, light, and medium, we refer to difficulty, just in general, meaning volume and intensity as well. Speaking about intensity, we also look at relative intensity and also absolute intensity. Okay, so you can actually max out with 5 repetition, but with an easier exercise, let's say like front squat is relatively lighter than the back squat, would always be around 50% lighter than the back squat. I can max out in the front squat, that will still be less absolute intensity. But I like to drop the relative intensity as well in medium and light workouts. You can drop the only the intensity, only the volume, or both. I like to drop both of them slightly. And then the light workout will be another step in that direction. So in the medium session, we don't do the top set. We save that for the once a week. Okay? We only have limited amount of that kind of effort. But we will take the 4 sets of 10 and we will do them with, let's say, 80 to 85% of the heavy session top set. Okay, so here we have 90%, the supplemental work. Here we perform 80 to 85%. So it's an initial 5 to 10% drop in intensity relative to the heavy session. And in the light session, we can do 4 sets of 10 at, let's say, 70 to 75 or 80 to 85. So an additional 5 to 10% drop in intensity relative to the medium session. Okay, so another step in that direction. You can also drop the volume and you can do just 3 sets of 10 with 80 to 75. How do you know how much weight you need? You will feel it, okay? Medium and light session should feel lighter. If the medium workout feels too heavy, you're walking too heavy. As simple as that. The light session should really fly. We're talking light weights, no struggle, maybe RPE. One to five, and then the medium workout, it does possess some difficulty. Maybe it will be around 4 to 7. And here the RPEs would be in the heavy workout, maybe in the 6 to 10, okay? The top set will be a 10. You shouldn't keep anything in reserve. Maybe the subsequent sets, maybe the first one will be an RPE 6-7, but gradually increasing each and every set. So that will be the medium, that will be the light workout, and then you have a complete week. This is our programming for the planche. This is a great general template, I believe, in order to achieve straddle planche and front lever, full front lever hold. You can take and should take that template and make it accustomed to your needs. Do accessories that target your weak muscle groups. Maybe that's the biceps, maybe it's not. Maybe you have huge arms, you should work on the chest more, on the core, on the legs. You should attribute more volume into these weak links in the accessories. Maybe you're seeking variation. So the supplemental work, the additional subsequent sets, would be a variation of the isometric straddle planche hold. Either way, we have a rationale here with the programming, specificity, overload. We have a progression model, something to expect. We have an autoregulatory system inserted within each week. And you have enough recovery, I believe, when programmed right, to hit the next heavy session real heavy. So the light and the medium workouts are not because I'm a sissy. Those are relatively lighter workouts, so you can actually work out heavier here. Most people just do medium, medium, medium. Not going heavy enough and not going light enough anytime. They're just in this mediocre range. So heavy, light, medium is actually a template that you can actually walk heavy with. That is the programming for the planche. Please, if you have any question regarding programming for the planche, drop a comment down below and I will try to help you with that. Also, you can maybe give me an idea of what video I can do next. That will help a lot. And see you next video.